Good morning.
Good morning.
How's everyone?
Fine.
It's sunny and no snow. Our call to worship. The Spirit blows life through us all.
We gather to celebrate this life-giving Spirit.
The Spirit breaks down all barriers and walls.
We give thanks to the Spirit, both giver and gift.
We have come to celebrate the birthday of our church.
We have come to celebrate the gift of Pentecost.
To open ourselves to God's enlivened Spirit. As bubbling laughter,
as healing touch,
and the small, still voice of peace. And our prayer of approach.
Loving God, we thank you for today.
And for that day long ago, when you poured yourself out in a new and marvelous way to renew your people and your creation.
We thank you.
I hope you don't get shocked, but our opening hymn is number 222, and I invite you to stand if you're able. Been asked to make one announcement, and that is that the book sale will continue after service. Are there other announcements? The board meeting is on Thursday? Wednesday. I know it's in my book. Other announcements? Then you can remain seated and we'll do hymn number 299, verses 1 and 2, and I'm turning it over to celebrate the children.
Thank you.
I guess I'm the chair of the C committee. So today is our Celebration Sunday, and you know how we love to party, so I won't start bragging about that yet, but I'll let you know later what we're doing. So first of all, I welcome to our Church School Celebration Sunday. The Church School is a vital part of the life and work of the Church. Today we celebrate the fun, the sharing, the learning, and the growing that has been a part of Sunday School this past year. We say thank you to those who have made this year's program possible, the CE Committee, for all their help and support, Colleen Garreau, for being the glue who holds everything together and also sends out all the emails and letters to the families. We couldn't do it without her. Most importantly, we thank and celebrate the ministry of the teachers who have taught our children and encouraged their faith. We also celebrate the enthusiasm and gifts which the children have shared with us. At this time, I'd like to call forward all of the CE committee, just so you guys can see them. They are a wonderful group of ladies and gentlemen. I think we're all here, so come on forward. As well as, I'm going to get the children to come up and stand here, okay? Colleen, could you grab Jackie out of the baby fold, please? First, I'd like to thank our teachers. I just want the kids up here because they're so beautiful, and I want you guys all to get a chance to have a good look at them. I'd like to thank our teachers. We have Wendy Weeb, who helped out this year. She's, of course, at the lake. It's camping season, so she's at the lake. We had Dorothy Walker, who helped out, and you all know Dorothy Walker. She's been a longtime helper, and she does a great job, and again, she's camping for the weekend. We have Anne Evans, we all know, has been our faithful teacher for, I don't know, forever?
Years.
Forever. We have Shelley Finley, again, a teacher forever. I don't know what's going to happen when you ladies tell us no. We have a newcomer this year, Raylene, come on over here so we can see you. This is one of our new teachers. She's also just jumped right on the CE committee, and thankfully to Raylene, she's taken over the promotion part of the party that we're having. Lots of stuff. I didn't have to do any work for that, so thank you, Raylene. I really appreciate it. And Jackie, come on over here. We appreciate Jackie. She's not downstairs with us, but she's a faithful baby fold lady, and I'm going to give you a hug. Because again, I don't know what we're going to do when Jackie decides to leave us, so... And I don't have a gift for Colleen, but as we all know, she's always by our side helping us out, so we appreciate that. Just going to introduce our committee to you. We have Nicole Jones, or Nikki, Janet Olmstead-Wood. I forgot your name, girl. I don't know your last name.
Pagoski.
Amber. Shelley Finney. Anne is on our committee. Nicole Garreau is on our committee, as well as Raylene and Greg... is in the baby fold. And of course, Colleen is a helper and myself. So we have a great committee and they're always helping out. So I want to say thank you to you as a CE committee. Could we give them a clap? Okay, and I'm going to hand this over and Anne is going to name off the names of our kids. And I want you to notice the difference from last year. We got more kids, isn't this great? Next year we're going to even have more, so...
Skip those two. Are the Chabadis up there? No.
No.
Okay. There you go, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Hi there. Could we have Nick Finley, please? Congratulations. Haley Finley. These two have been wonderful helpers the whole year. Brendan. Keegan Fryheit. Again, Keegan helps with the little ones. Wynn Hebert. Oh.
take your paper?
Riley Freiheit. Kate Jaska. Kiara. Hi. Megan Jaska.
Hi, Megan. Hey, you missed my hand.
Zara Clark Jones.
Hi, Zara. You're
welcome. Ella Campbell. Congratulations. Aiden Campbell. Luke Pogorski.
Pogorski. Yeah, I'm the only one that can say it. Congratulations, bud.
Hi, Nick.
Congratulations.
Nolan Pogorski.
Congratulations, Nolan.
Jesse.
Beautiful lady. There you go. I like that dress.
And Calder Elliott. Hi, Calder.
Good job, buddy.
Thank you.
Aren't they a wonderful group? I did forget to thank someone, and I wrote it on this morning so I wouldn't forget, our sound people. We really appreciate Greg and Shannon Leachman for doing all the work they do for us, because I never prepare them ahead of time. We walk in and say, I need. So thank you, Greg and Shannon, for all your hard work, too.
Is Jade here? Is Jade here?
We also every year do a high school graduation. For the high school graduates. I don't know if Jade is here. Is Jade Hagen here? Okay. I'm just going to acknowledge that we do have two youth graduating from our Sunday school program this year from high school. We have Jade Hagen, who will be graduating from Crocus, and Tori Rust, who will be graduating from Massey. And neither one of them were able to attend, but we do have a little congratulation gift for them. So, okay, we are ready to go party. One thing we do have to do before we go, we do need to do a little church stuff, so we need to say a prayer. So if you guys could all join in for the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against
us, and lead us not
into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Does anybody know how to shut this off? Awesome.
Let us pray our prayer of confession. We confess that sometimes we have trouble loving our neighbors.
Often we do not understand others.
Misunderstanding fills us with fear and keeps us from being the loving, caring people you want us to be.
Forgive us our failure, in Jesus' name. Amen.
God's Spirit comes to break down our walls of indifference and enables us to reach out to one another with love. Through Christ, our sins are forgiven.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. lies the great and mighty sea, teeming with living things both great and small.
Upon it sail the ships, and there is the Leviathan, the monster you made to play in it.
All these look to you, to give them their food in due season.
When you give them to gather up, when you open your hand, you fill them with good things.
But when you hide your face, they despair. When you take away their breath, they die and return to dust.
But when you send out your spirit, they live again, and you renew the face of the earth.
Endure forever.
May you rejoice, O God, in your works.
When you look at the earth, it trembles.
When you touch the mountains, they smoke.
I will sing to God as long as I live.
I will praise my God while I have being.
From John chapter 14, verses 8 to 17. Philip said to him, Jesus, show us the Creator, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Creator. How can you say, Show us the Creator? Do you not believe that I am in the Creator and the Creator is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Creator who dwells in me does this work. Believe me that I am in the Creator and the Creator is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do. In fact, will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Creator. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Creator may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Creator, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Creator will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. The next reading is from Genesis chapter 11, verses 1 to 9. Now the whole earth had one language and the same words. And as they migrated from the east, they came upon a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. And they said to one another, Come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens. Let us make a name for ourselves, otherwise we shall be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. The Lord came down to see the city and the tower, which mortals had built. And the Lord said, Look, they are one people, and they have all one language, and this is only the beginning of what they will do. Nothing that they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language there, so that they will not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from there over the face of all the earth, and they left off building the city. Therefore, it was called Babel, meaning confuse, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth, and from there the Lord scattered them abroad over the face of all the earth. And the next reading is Acts chapter 2, verses 1 to 21. When the day of the Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven, and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Now there were staying in Jerusalem God-fearing Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard this sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. Utterly amazed, they asked, "Are not all these men who are speaking Galileans? Then how is it that each of us hears them in his own native language? Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya near Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, we hear them declaring the wonders of God in our own tongues." Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, "What does this mean?" Some, however, made fun of them and said, "They have had too much wine." Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and addressed the crowd. "Fellow Jews and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These men are not drunk, as you suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved."
Here's wisdom for our lives. I wonder what kind of lifestyle these people have when they were considering the fact that the guys couldn't be drunk at 9 o'clock in the morning. Pentecost means 50th. It's the Greek name for a Jewish festival of Shabbat, which occurs 50 days after Passover. In biblical times, Jews from all over the Roman Empire would have tried to get to Jerusalem to celebrate this feast. After the destruction of the temple in the year 70, the feast was transformed from an observance of the first harvest to the giving of the law on Mount Sinai. Pentecost represents the number of days that supposedly passed between the Passover and the arrival of the Israelites at Mount Sinai. The Christian church also claims Pentecost as a festival day, falling at the end of the 50 days of Easter. On Pentecost, we celebrate God's life-giving Spirit poured out abundantly on the community of disciples. We have rich images of wind and fire framing the proclamation of God's power in words that we cannot understand. Community is extended by the Spirit's blessing through a diversity of persons and a diversity of gifts, all for the common good. Fear has kept many a person behind closed doors, in closets, and under wraps. The only remedy for fear is peace. The peace that Christ gives. The disciples' fear keeps them behind locked doors. And in John's gospel, Jesus tells them the Spirit, sends them the Spirit as a guide, comforter, helper, and advocate. Jesus promises that the disciples will not be alone. The Spirit transforms, empowers, guides, sustains, and gives hope. The good news of the text is that Jesus is able to break through our closets and bring peace. What are the locked doors in each of your lives that you might wish Jesus would pass through? The festival of Pentecost is linked with the gift of the law at Sinai. God's law and covenant were the foundation of the community of Israel. In our focus reading in Acts, the foundation of a new community is formed in a living covenant through God and through the body of Christ. Act 2 reminds us of an amazing day. It was a chaotic and confusing event, but amidst all that uproar, Peter preached the good news of Jesus. The gift of this text to any marginalized community is the phrase, "We hear them declaring wonders of God in our own tongues." The statement recognizes that we all want to know the wonders of God in our own culture and in our own context. Whether we are First Nations, foreign nationals in Canada, or deaf folk in a hearing world. In the passage, the Spirit lights upon a particular people in the upper room, but it is not confined to that closed door experience. Those that have had a fiery, blistery experience with God that shakes their very foundations, they must share it with others. That gathered crowd marvels as they hear the gospel in their native language. Explanations of how this might have taken place pale in comparison to the words that were conveyed. When one hears the gospel in your own language, how is it possible to ignore the Pentecost truth that God comes in the Spirit to each and every one of us? Peter and the disciples are witnesses to God's act of grace and love in Christ and an international assembly receives their words. Acts lists an intriguing variety of peoples that make up the crowd that day. In spite of critics who question their authenticity, the disciples continue to speak the truth they know. The experience of the Holy Spirit always also enlarges our mission far beyond anything we might earlier have envisioned. And it always calls us to include people within our mission who we might have earlier regarded as not quite worthy of God's grace. But in God's eyes, no person can ever not be worthy. The Spirit includes everyone. The Genesis passage is read today because it's directly related to the story of Pentecost. We are shown how God's Spirit, experienced at Pentecost, enabled people to hear and understand one another again. Diversity does not necessarily mean confusion and fear. The Spirit overcomes all human boundaries, even the boundaries of different languages. Putting the Acts story with the Genesis story emphasizes that any unity within humanity will be brought about by God and will include diversity. It will not be some kind of totalitarian unity created through the stamping out of diversity. This mighty work of God's Spirit is celebrated in the Psalm 104, singing of God's Spirit breathing life upon all creatures, not just human beings. God's Spirit renews the face of the earth. Psalm 104 also testifies that God in wisdom created everyone and everything on earth, a variety that is teeming beyond number. It also has some delightful passages. Just remember that verse 26. The sea contains ships and Leviathan that you formed just so it could play in the sea. Pentecost is about the energy and strength which comes from being enlivened by God's Spirit. Pentecost is about freedom from fear and release from a locked door mentality. Janet Morley in Bread of Tomorrow says it's about the power of the Spirit to integrate profound changes of the heart with exuberant and effective action. It's about celebrating the diverse ways in which God's Spirit works. Pentecost Sunday celebrates the animating and sustaining presence of God's Spirit within the church. Perhaps it's the reason that Pentecost is often called the birthday of the Christian church. The Spirit gives the church its mission and the power to undertake it. As you look into your future, what mission is the Spirit giving to you and to Central United? God bless us on our journey. I invite you to stand as you are able for hymn number 195. We bring many gifts. We represent many traditions. We embody many understandings of the truth. Within our diversity and variety, may we unite our hearts in faith and love as we give our gifts to God's work through church, local, national, and international. Our offering will now be gathered. Places of hurt, places of injustice, places of despair, into places of hope, love, and celebration. Amen. Before we begin our communion prayer, a reminder that everyone here is invited to this table. It is an open table. It is a table of God. It is not the table of United Church or the table of Central. For those of you who need gluten-free, Darlene will have the bread. We have two people who will roam through, so if you are not able to come forward to receive, stay in your pew, raise your hand, and the two wanderers will come and find you. This is my last communion. And when the time came, Jesus sat at the table and his followers with him.
And the time has come again, and we sit at our table, and Jesus is with us.
And he took a cup and gave thanks.
And as we raised our cup in a toast to our Creator and Benefactor, who gives us land, water, animals, air, and harvest. We do thank our God for all that we have in him.
And he took bread and broke it and said, "This is my body."
We too are the broken body of Christ, for we have failed to bring healing and grace to all those in pain and distress. In turn, we have been robbed of our dignity as the children of God and cannot be the yeast and the bread of life. We have been trampled by those who use us for their own selfishness and greed.
And Jesus turned to his friends and said, "Do."
Speak, protest, write, march, petition, walk, announce, proclaim, brave, protect, preach, and pray.
Do this.
Feed, comfort, and nurse those in need. Visit, clothe, and heal those in pain. Bring the God in you to meet God in others who feel God forsaken.
Do this in remembrance
of all our ancestors and descendants, of those prophets and saints who have given us God's word, of our brothers and sisters who are killed, lost, or made to disappear, for daring to speak your word of love, to those who oppress and beat us. We remember and they live.
Do this in remembrance of me. And the Christ said, "The hand of one who betrays me is at this table."
We cringe in fear of whom that may be, and fail to see that it is all of us. We have helped hide the realm of God's presence in this world of war, hunger, thirst, pain, disease, greed, selfishness, and pride. What can we do, and how shall we realize ourselves?
Would someone go get the children and let them know it's time? The resurrected one calls us to come and eat and feast. Do this in remembrance of me.
We come to celebrate the new life we have received in Christ, the new life given to us to share. We eat and drink to nourish ourselves for our work. It is our work to tell the world of God's coming and to proclaim the hidden presence of God's coming and to proclaim the hidden presence of God's realm here and now in our lives.
The feast is prepared. Come and eat and remember and celebrate. Their prayers. May we never forget the world, O God.
May we never walk past what needs to be transformed, but with your spirit may we become unchanged.
In conflict, may we be peace. In hunger, may we be bread. In prejudice, may we be friendship. May we never forget the world, O God. In deceit, may we be truth. In community, may we be justice. In poverty, may we be empowerment. In silence, may we be a voice. May we never forget the world, O God.
May we never walk past what needs to be transformed, but with your spirit, may we become change.
In darkness, may we be light. In dogma, may we be renewal. In faith, may we be welcome. In certainty, may we be questions. May we never forget the world, O God.
May we never walk past what needs to be transformed, but with your spirit, may we become changed.
As members of the human race and as your children, we pray today for our brothers and sisters in Kenya and Tanzania. We pray for our mission partners who use our facilities on a regular basis, especially today for Healthy Baby Program. We also pray for the following special days. The 17th is International Day Against Homophobia. The 21st has lots of festivities. On that day, Buddhists celebrate Visakha Day, the birth, enlightenment, and death of Gautama Buddha. The same day, Shintos celebrate the Three Shrine Festival, three-day festival honoring the three founders of the oldest Buddhist temple in Tokyo. And on sunset at that day, Muslims celebrate a night of repentance and forgiveness in preparation for Ramadan, a month-long fasting. We pray for those who are in need, those we know and those we don't know. We ask that all who are sick in mind, body, or soul will meet someone who will be your presence to them. I invite you to dance as you are able in hymn number 23, Come, O Holy Spirit, in More Voices. Hymn number 23, and I mean dance. That Jesus spoke to the disciples long ago. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives.
Amen.